Yo, what's up, people? What's going on, man? I know I haven't uploaded in a while, but you know, this video I feel like was necessary, you know, to educate the community about some pitchers that you should avoid. And not just because of their overall rating or their stuff. Like, for example, this Jake Arrieta, everybody wants him. Everybody's saying he's one of the best in-game starting pitchers, but I'm telling you why you shouldn't get him. And give you example with live gameplay why you shouldn't. And also got a few bullpen arms. Now, most people probably know where I'm coming at, you know. Nate Jones, for example. Nate Jones and some other pitchers I'm gonna point out. But yeah, most pitchers you could probably figure this out with, depending on their delivery. But these pitchers, if you ever have like Jake Arrieta and wonder why he's getting crushed every time you run with him, it's because he tips his pitches. Nate Jones as well. If you wondering why your pitchers are underperforming, this is the reason why. They give away their pitches before they've even thrown. So I'm gonna tell you to avoid these pitches. I'm gonna show you footage. Like, this footage right here is from the events, this past events that just came up. You know, he got Jake Arrieta in the game. Right now I'm down 2-0. You know, I'm pretty sure, like, I'm gonna show you slow motion. Like, you see the two fingers on the ball. That's a sinker. I seen it coming before. You know, it helps me recognize what's coming and everything, get my timing down. So I'm looking at it again. Slow motion. You see the two fingers on the ball. It's either fastball or sinker, one of those two. So you see how I pulled it. I was anticipating that the whole way through, and I pulled the fuck out that pitch. And it was inside too. So you have it. I'm gonna show you another example. Let me see if I can get a slider in this video right here. Let's see. Another fastball he throwing. Yep, another fastball. And I pulled it again. Once again, this is Jake Arrieta, and he's already up 2-0. So he got a comfortable lead on me. And I'm up here saying to myself, like, I can't have Jake Arrieta because he's so easy to read. This is why. Now, you know, with the YouTube compression, I don't know if you can see the the fingers is high quality as I see them when I'm playing the game, but that's the only way you could stop your opponent from seeing his pitches, doing that quick pitch when you're on the that I couldn't read what he was throwing me when he was doing that. But watch right here. As soon as he goes into the regular stretch, I can read his pitch, and I turned on it. I turned on the fastball. I think it was a fastball or a changeup. It was one of those two. We'll see. And I end up scoring, and I end up taking the lead. And he was up with Jake Arrieta, with the 99 Jake Arrieta, by the way. Now, this is Jake Diekman. Jake Diekman is like a left-handed Nate Jones right here. He's throwing me a fastball. You see the two fingers on there. It's either a sinker or a fastball. Now, here's another example. You can clearly see two fingers together. It's a slider. Watch. See, it's a slider. I'm able to recognize his pitches, like, real easy. So, here's Nate Jones right here. This is the main guy. You can really see his pitches. Look at that. Two fingers apart, fastball. I turned on it. Turned on it so easily. And Nate Jones throws gas. So I seen it coming for you through it. Here's another example. Two fingers, is that apart or together? I think that's apart. Two fingers apart. Once again, I was able to read it. Got all over that shit. Now, for example, these are some quick clips or whatever. Now, if you facing any pitcher and you trying to read their pitches, two fingers together is a breaking ball. Two fingers apart is a fastball. Of course, you see my opponent concedes because I just blew the game open on him because he had every single pitcher was a pitcher I could read. Now, this Joe Nathan also tips his pitches, but not as obvious as the other pitchers I just shown. Right here, he threw me a fastball. I was all over it. Now, Joe Nathan tips his pitches, but not as obvious as Arrieta and Nate Jones, obviously. But you could still see them. Now, as I was saying before, if you see the pitcher having two fingers spread out, it's a fastball. Two fingers together, it's a curveball or a slider or a cutter. You know, three fingers on the ball, that's for sure a changeup. Those are easily recognizable. As you see right here, Joe Nathan threw me a slider. And I was all over it. I was able to ride it to the right field. And this was an important run because I was down 2-0 late in the game. As soon as he brought in Joe Nathan, I couldn't hit him at all. And I just went crazy on him. Like, I finally scored my first run. It's the top of the fifth inning. And this is an offense, by the way. And that one I was able to pull down the line. And I'm just... he's streaking right here now. Now, I will assume that everybody plays on strike zone cam. And I assume that the strike zone camera is the only camera view that you are able to read the pitcher's the hands as accurately as that. And plus, a big screen TV helps too. There's another fastball down the middle. I was able to read it through his fucking motion. That's why I wouldn't buy Joe Nathan. I think if Joe Nathan had a deceptive delivery, he'd be like one of the best pitchers in the game. But his delivery, you could easily read it. And like I said, I'm coming back in the game. This is Stanton. This once again was a Vince game. Like, this is two outs. All these hits came on two outs. And I was able to read that, you know, I hit a 3-1 home run and basically blew the game wide open with him. So yeah, once again, I'm telling you guys, if you got Nate Jones, Jake Diekman, Arrieta basically, and you wondering why they getting killed, take them out your lineup, man. Honestly, if you was a high-level player, I wouldn't put those guys in your lineup just for this reason alone. You may be able to get away with it in lower divisions, like with pitchers like this that tips their pitches, but you fighting in the high divisions, like, you can't have this going against you. So, yeah, just avoid these pitchers, you know. And as you see, I'm going to town on Joe Nathan. As soon as he brought him in the game, it was over. So I get happy as hell when I'm down and I see somebody bring in, you know, Nate Jones or somebody that I know that could tip their pitches. So yeah, this video basically an education of what pitches to avoid, and I gave y'all proof of why it doesn't work. Now, some of these are advanced, some of these are ranked season games. So yeah, just avoid these pitchers at all costs. You know, don't look at their stuff and you think, oh, it's good, but you know, it's not good. So anyway, yeah, like and subscribe. I hope this helped y'all. I hope to upload more. I haven't uploaded in a while because I got a job, and my job really been taking my time from me uploading. So I'm going to try to upload more. Anyway, that was my 12th win of that event. You know, I went 12 wins twice, so whatever. So anyway, peace, guys. I'll talk to y'all later.